See your skin.
Yes. Thank you very much to the organizers of this fourth international and heart failure conference of Sir Sri Lanka Medical College. Thanks to Kader, who needs extra congratulations from me. My topic is PCI versus CABG for left main coronary disease. What is missing here? I have to tell it in 10 minutes. Background. Left main coronary disease associated high morbidity and mortality owing to large amount of myocardial arteries. This you know very much, very well. Everybody is telling that. Randomized trials have suggested that percutaneous coronary intervention with juggling stents might be an acceptable alternative for selected patients with left main coronary disease. That also known to you. But what we face every day when asked, most patients prefer the less invasive PCI over surgery. That is the reason. And what the guideline says, you see, the guidelines in 2018 guidelines, in ESC guidelines, the less the syntax score, the, I can minimize it. Less the syntax score, the class of evidence, class of recommendation and evidence are more in favorable of PCI. The more when the syntax is 33, the recommendation is 3 for PCI. And the main comparative study, the first RCT of left main coronary intervention published. And what it found, death similar between CABG and stenting. Death QMI and I think QMI and death QMI and other, I cannot read. The PCI and CABG has got no significant difference. But target vessel revascularization, in case of target vessel revascularization, there is a significant difference. CABG is favorable. And the left main intervention should be selective. Then comes the intervention procedures, more selectivity of the left main. There are numerous papers being submitted that trying to improve the selection of left main stenting. That is what the considerations are, geometry of the left main and the bifurcation angles, hemodynamic assessment of circumference compression of crossover stenting, adverse outcomes when multiple stents are needed, improved predictive models using clinical information in addition to the syntax score. What the syntax trial said? Syntax trials 10-year survival. After ESC presented in ESC Congress in 2019 in Paris, the result demonstrated equivalence in the primary endpoint of all-cause mortality. You see, p-value is significant, non-significant. There are no difference of left main disease or diabetics. P-value is not significant. Survival benefit in three vessel disease, high syntax score category, it is more in favor of CABG. And MES at 5 years, you see, before 1 year, 1 to 2 years, 2 to 3 years, 3 to 4 years, 4 to 5 years, there is no significant difference between CABG and DEXA stent. But the MES at 5 years, with syntax score more than 33, then it comes that CABG is better than DEXA. When intermediate, there is no significant difference between DEXA and CABG. There is no significant difference in DEXA CABG in lower scores. When do I send for PCI? It is short, no? Jai, can't take it. It is me put the participant. It is short, the participant. It is. I operate. Age. Ever short. Yes. When do I send a three vessel disease and or a unprotected left main patient for CABG? High syntax score with three vessel disease and or left main disease. Intermediate syntax score with three vessel disease, no. Borderline syntax score patients, IDDMs always meet towards CABG. DAPT intolerant patient, total occlusion with large and important territory at risk, not amenable to PCI or failed PCI, severe restenosis, large territory at risk, poor PCI candidate. That is the excessive proximal toxicity, particularly if calcified with good distal target. When do I break the above rules? Poor CABG candidates, that is frailty, oxygen dependent, no targets, patient preference, especially when syntax score borderline. Next, study by Greg Jasper. Primary endpoint, all-cause death, stroke, MI at median 3 years, there is no difference between PCI and CABG. At 5 years, it is also not different. PCI hazards, you see, by months, 1 month, CABG has got death, stroke, and MI more. But gradually, when it comes to 60 months, that is 5 years, that is death, stroke more in PCI group. But distal lament bifurcation only, the unprotected, that is unplanned revascularization is more common with PCI group. An excellent study, there is femoral is 72%, radial was 26%. And they do it brachial also 0.2%. Conclusion, in the Excel trial, treatment of patients with LMCA and visually assessed low and intermediate syntax with cobalt chromium everolimus eluting stent result is similar rates of the clinically meaningful composite outcome of death, stroke, and MI at 5 years. The early benefits of PCI due to reduced periposterior risk were attenuated by greater number of events occurring during follow-up of CABG such that at 5 years, the cumulative mean time free from brush events was similar in both treatment. PCI may thus be considered an acceptable revascularization modality for selected patients with left and CAD, a decision which should be made after heart-team discussion, taking into account each patient's risk factors and preferences. The heart team, and shared decision-making are overrated. What the Lehman's trial said, I have to take it up again. The Lehman, the inpatient's unprotected left main coronary artery stenosis, low and medium complexity of coexisting coronary artery disease, stenting offers numerically, but study non-significant favorable outcome up to 10 years in terms of safety and efficacy outcome measures, therefore constitutes an alternative therapy for CABG. What the pre-combat study said, during 5 years follow-up, the study did not show significant difference regarding the rate of MES between patients who underwent PCI with sirolimus eluting stent and those underwent CABG. However, considering the limited power of the study, the results should be interpreted with caution. Summary, this is written in 2020. This contemporary meta-analysis reports CABG as being superior to PCI when it comes to vascular resistance with asset high anatomical complexity. It is also adds to a well-established body of evidence that now supports an equipoise between PCI and CABG in patients with left-main CAD, how to low to intermediate syntax scores. But ethnic reciprocity is golden rule. Do not unto others what you would not have others to do. This is the whole law. The rest merely commentaries upon it, say 2,000 years back. Thank you.